Welcome back. Time now for 814 Good, sponsored by our friends at McMullen Furniture. Mike, I thought we would end with something fun and quirky.
Good.
Try to get people's minds off what's about to happen.
All
the election coverage right here on WTAJ. Do not change the channel. But first, this next story may have you doing a double take, maybe even a triple take, and it may even have you scratching your head. But a Kansas man behind the memorable motorcycle you're about to see tells you, just roll with it.
Call in the investigators. We have a mouthpiece next to a cowbell. Is that a tiger in an upside down shoe?
I've had people literally take their shoes off and hang them on the bike.
If you're questioning what this all is,
some people call it art, some people call it junk.
Lyle Powers.
I get people that can't believe I did this to a motorcycle.
Has your answers.
The stories people get to share, that's the best part of doing what I do.
That doing started in 2009. Powers was riding his Harley in Colorado when he found an elk bone.
Got a wild hair and decided I'd attach it to the bike.
A decade later, it's still here, along with just about anything else you can think of.
People comment on my bedpan a lot.
As silly as it may seem, that bedpan and mannequin leg
makes a great place to put your coffee pot.
Each have a unique story tied to a unique person.
What's really neat is I'll be in another state and somebody will come up and go, oh man, I signed your bike 2 years ago, and they'll find their signature.
The signatures and oh so many miscellaneous items go back years. Powers hopes their stories go on forever.
Nothing like the sound of a sweet, sweet honk. That's what
right,
I say.
Right, Rebecca.
Every motorcycle enthusiast or biker is like, take that woman off the TV.
Yeah.
But how cool is it that people come up to him and say, hey, I remember signing your bike 2 years ago.
And then finding their name. That's cool. One thing I thought of is, what happens if it like breaks down and the mechanics have to get into this bike and fix it? Or I assume you could probably take these things off easily.
Yeah, I don't think
they're glued on, maybe.
He probably knows how to do it himself, I'm hoping. And what if he's like, no, don't touch the bedpan.
Yeah, right.
Make sure you don't touch that.
Oh, man.
But really cool, and actually, if I ever see him riding across Central PA, I want to sign that bike.
Yeah, me too.
Love
actually
it.
Cool.
Thanks for joining me, Mike.
Of course.
And thank you for joining us at home. Now it's time for your 5 o'clock news.